Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video, let's get started with Next.js. We will do the installation and setup, which is very easy. Before that, we'll talk about one simple Next.js application. So I was checking this application and this is Next.js server side rendered application. And you can see on the index page what all things it is downloading on the page. You can see all the meta tags for search engine optimization it is rendering. Each and every meta tags, some meta tags for the Facebook attributes, title, description, image, Twitter card information. Okay, then you can see in the bottom it has server side rendered HTML and even the CSS also. So whenever the browser or browser interprets this document, it start building it because it has everything what it needs. It has styles and it has JavaScript also in this page somewhere in the bottom. So I just try to format this. You can see the server side rendered HTML. So if HTML is coming up, CSS is coming up in the same page, then you can see the rendering will, initial rendering will be faster. You can start seeing the page. You can start seeing the building of the page and you can see, okay, content is appearing. Now in the bottom, you can see the JavaScript, right? So initially you will see the styles, you will see the HTML and you will start seeing the page getting built, right? On the initial phase, like in some particular milliseconds, then it will download these JavaScript runtime JavaScript, which is main bundle, common bundle, webpack bundle, which are Next.js final bundle files, and it is async loading, right? We are using async tag here, so it will just defer these loading of these JavaScript files. It will not become a blocker in the critical path of web page rendering. You can see async is being used. So the JavaScript will execute, will download it and then execute, and then your page will become interactable in the final phase, not in the initial phase. In the initial phase, you will just see the page is getting appearing. So you can see the page start appearing initially. You can see the server side rendering is so much faster here. The page is appearing and then it's just a simple page, just an HTML, right? Now coming back to the installation and setup. So basic things you need is you just need a one VS Code editor, Node.js installed on your system. That's it. You can get started. And we can use NPX. You no need to install any module globally. NPX create React app. Create next app, sorry. So create next app and here you can install. You can actually create a simple application. If you wanted to do a manual setup, just create a package.json and install next, React and React DOM. We are using React and React DOM, I mean React framework with Next to do the server side rendering. And then in the script tag, just do Next dev. This will start your server. Okay, so that we will see. And then you can start creating your basic components. Like this is homepage component. The component we are going to create is same as what we were doing in React. Okay, the only things which will change is the routing in Next.js is different from the create React app we were doing. We were using React Router DOM. Here it will be using Next Router. Okay, some other library. Similarly, for making an API call, getting some external data, we were using these lifecycle methods in the functional component or class-based component. Things will be a bit different here. We will be using some different set of methods. Okay, so here you can see a CLI application also you can use. NPX next edge and you can actually create a basic application. Next build profile. So we'll start with the basic application, how to get started with this. Okay, and then what we just need to do is in the pages folder, we just need to start creating the individual components like about component, home component, contact component, and Next.js is capable of linking all these on different routes. Okay, you will create about, contact, all these pages, and then you will be able to link them together. Okay, so getting started, we can just simply do this. NPX create next app. Okay. So here, let me zoom this a little bit. So we can just simply use this. So create next app will help us to what is your project name. Okay, so let's say Okay, so we need to change it. And then you can see it is installing these three dependencies only initially. Next, React DOM and next, right? And your application will start. We'll just do. It is also installing all the required packages, and it will give us the basic skeleton of the folders. Then we just need to do npm run dev or yarn dev. That will just start the next year server. Okay, this will take time. So let's see this in the next video. Thanks, everyone.